Thank you, Dr. Seo. My name is Siva. I'm one of the cardiac surgeons. I come from Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. So Dr. Seo has given me the kind opportunity to explain to you about some specimens that we have on Tetralogy of Fallot. Right. So before going to the actual specimen of Tetralogy of Fallot, I would like to just show you brief a normal anatomy so that you will have a better appreciation in a patient with the condition of Tetralogy of Fallot. You can see here, this is the normal specimen of the heart. Let's come here, all right. Okay, so this is basically, you can see here, the right atrium. Why do you call it the right atrium? Right atrium here, yeah. And it shows a broader base compared to the left atrium. And this is the left atrial appendage, which, as you can see here, it has got a narrow base. And as you look through the right atrium, this is the right ventricular inflow portion. And you can see the tricuspid valve into the inflow portion. And then if you just flip the right ventricle that has been cut, you can see the inflow portion of the right ventricle with the tricuspid leaflets here. And this is the trabecular portion of the right ventricle. And you can see here is the right ventricular outflow tract. So if you look in this specimen, there is a septum, a muscular septum that is separating the pulmonary artery from the right ventricle. So this is actually the infundibular septum. And this particular infundibular septum is the key feature in the Tetralogy of Fallot, which causes the various pathologies within the disease condition. But if you compare the same particular heart specimen on the right side to the left side, you can see the left ventricular inflow tract over here, the left atrium going into the left ventricle through the mitral valve. And if you look at the same portion, this is the trabecular portion of the left ventricle, and this is the outflow portion of the left ventricle. In this left ventricle, you can see the aorta here with the aortic valves. This is the outlet portion, and you can see the mitral valves lower down here. So you don't have this so-called infundibular septum or a muscular separation between the aortic valve and the mitral valve. So it's a direct continuity. So that is how you differentiate whether it's a right ventricular outflow tract or whether it's a left ventricular outflow tract. Now, getting back into this specimen again, the key point in Tetralogy of Fallot is this particular infundibular portion. This infundibular septum is the one that is going to deviate anterior cephalad portion. That means it goes up here. So basically, this deviation of the septum is what causes the narrowing of the right ventricular outflow tract, and that effectively causes the overriding of the aorta and a creation of a ventricular septal defect. So now from here, if I can just shift to a specimen of unoperated Tetralogy of Fallot. This is a neonatal heart. It's very sad. Probably the child didn't reach the surgeon to do the correction. So so this is what has happened here. You can see in a similar manner, you can see this is the right ventricle, right atrium that you can appreciate, which has got a very broad base. And this is the, superior vena cava that enters into the right atrium. And below is supposed the inferior vena cava here. And now if you look here in this particular specimen, I will focus more into this the area of the outflow tract. Here you can see that this is the right ventricular outflow tract. And you can see this particular infundibular septum. This has kind of deviated quite anteriorly, and that has effectively narrowed down the right ventricular outflow tract. This is the right ventricular outflow tract that is going, which is looking quite small. that enters into the right pulmonary artery and the left pulmonary artery, and that has caused a bit of a narrowing because of this cephalate anterior deviation of this infundibular septum. Now, if I go just below this infundibular septum and I put my put a forceps into this, it effectively, you can see that this particular forceps comes out onto the left side. So this is basically showing a ventricular septal defect or an interventricular communication between the two ventricles. And moreover, if you can see over here, because of this anterior cephalad deviation, if I can put my forceps in here, it goes directly into the through the aortic valve into the aorta here. So basically what has happened is this aorta has kind of deviated deviated or override through the ventricular septum. Now, if you look at the key components in the tetralogy of Fallot, this right ventricular outflow tract causes an obstruction, and also there are two components in the surgical repair of tetralogy of Fallot. Number one is the closure of the ventricular septal defect, and number two is the relieving of the right ventricular outflow tract. So in a tetralogy of Fallot, if you look at the ventricular septal defect, you need to be you need to understand that the ventricular septal defect can be of different types. Okay, so basically you can have a totally muscular type of a ventricular septal defect. That means it is fully isolated between the just at the outflow portion, or it can go down all the way down to the perimembranous portion where it is in continuity of the septal leaflet. If you have a totally muscular covering, then this particular VSD is a bit easier to close because it is very unlikely for you to cause any heart block because it avoids the so-called membranous portion near the tricuspid valve. The key point is when you do a resection, you need to stick to your resection at the parietal band and also close to the septal band. Sometimes what can happen is this particular infundibular septum can be very hypertrophied. So there is sometimes you need to cut across the infundibular septum. There is one kind of a VSD which you can see in tetralogy of Fallot where you'll totally see an absence of this infundibular septum. So that means basically is the pulmonary artery will almost be in communication with the aortic valve, the pulmonary valve and the aortic valve. So that kind of VSD is usually the so-called Mexican type or the doubly committed subarterial type. In that kind of case, you will hardly see any infundibular septum. Now, when you go for the resection, you probably need to stick to this area, the parietal and the septal band, not extending down here, because sometimes in the tetralogy of Fallot, because of the severe hypertrophy of the right ventricle, you know that this is the tricuspid valve septal leaflet. You have the so-called the septomarginal trabeculations that come off. So be careful that you don't cut across that, because if you cut into that, you will distort the anatomy of the tricuspid apparatus, and you can cause severe tricuspid regurgitation. Another key point is if you see here at the infundibular septum, and this is the aortic valve and the tricuspid valve leaflet, at this portion you have a continuity. It is called the tricuspid, the continuity or the ventriculo infundibular fold is somewhere here and this portion. You need to be very careful here, because if you cut into that infundibular ventricular fold, you'll directly go outside the heart. So when you do the resection, try not to go lower down here. You mainly need to stick to this particular area, and here you can't see in this part is because it is cut across the right ventricular outflow tract. You can see that this is the right ventricular muscle, and below this, at this portion also, there's quite a bit of hypertrophied muscle. Sometimes you will need to make the resection through the pulmonary artery, or you can either make a ventriculotomy in order to widen that particular portion. So the next thing is you see the outflow tract here, And you can see that there's a significant narrowing of the right ventricular outflow tract because of this hypertrophied infundibulum. And you can see the pulmonary valves. They are pretty dysplastic-looking pulmonary valves. And you can also see that the pulmonary arteries are looking a bit small. But if you can go in to the right, to the left and to the right, you probably can... let's see here. All right. You can see that your forceps goes into the left, and this forceps over here basically goes into the right. Okay, so those seem to be quite okay. And you can see this particular patient, he's got a left-sided arch, and I think there are some, if I'm not mistaken, there are some small... Yeah, ductus that is somewhere, looks like it's been, is that cut?
No.
It's not the ductus, I don't know, I can't appreciate what it is, it's not very clear. But the key point over here is basically in this particular specimen, what you see is you see probably a very small neonate with the condition of tetralogy of Fallot. And he's got a severe infundibular, hypertrophied infundibulum with the narrowing of the right ventricular outflow tract. And he's got a overriding of aorta with a ventricular septal defect. And looks like this ventricular septal defect is almost extending to the, you know, to the tricuspid valve. And that's causing a huge outlet VSD to a perimembranous extension. Right?
Right.
Okay.
Thank you very much.